Hey, you may remember this guy as playing a doctor, Dr. Luca in ER, but now he's playing a time traveler, maybe teetering on the verge of good and evil. He looks kind of nice, but there's evil in there. Goran Visnjic, hey, congrats on everything, man.
Thank you.
Now, this is season two of the show, and yep. To my understanding, the show didn't die basically because the fans refused. Is that like what's that story?
It was pretty much something like that. We got canceled. Plain and simple, and fans really didn't like it. And social media, you know, all over the world just kind of exploded.
Really?
Can't do that. We really want to see what's happening and this and that. And then I was in Croatia actually doing a movie, and NBC called and they were like, you know what, guys, we kind of feel we made a mistake. Why don't we just bring the show back? You know, we're going to renegotiate and do things and this and that, you know. And we all agreed upon, you know, a little bit different conditions, because this year we're doing only 10 episodes, and we brought it back, and
wow.
I think it's better than last year because, you know, it's second season, so we kind of know what are we doing exactly, and it's really exciting this year. It's we just wrapped a couple of days ago, and this Sunday is episode 4 after a little break, Easter break.
So. God, if I ever get fired, I hope there's fans outside with tickets. a little bit about your character. He's an antagonist, or what? How can you describe your character?
Well, we started it the last season as kind of a guy who, you know, he's a bad guy.
Or is he a villain? Maybe he is a villain.
Well, he's, you know, now we know he's not. But in the first season, it was always kind of like you see in this scene, you know, he kind of like takes.
Well, that's not so right. Nice.
That is, yeah.
Now they use him kind of as a muscle in this season. But he's actually a very sweet guy. Very nice.
Right.
Yeah. Sweet guy. Yeah.
Deep inside. You know, just check it out. You'll
All
see
right,
what I'm
Timeless.
Talking
we have a clip of Timeless, so you guys take a peek at this.
The 22nd was the deadliest day of the witch trials. Gonna be brutal.
No way. You stole a time machine, you killed innocent people.
And you busted me out of jail.
The NSA suspects the Iranians, and I plan on keeping it that way. You are staying put.
Why do we have him here if we aren't gonna use him?
We're using him for intel, not muscle.
Oh, come on, guys! Fighting the good fight through time is kind of my wheelhouse. And I know all about Salem. You burned a couple witches in your day? Witches weren't burned in Salem, they were hanged. Of the accused, only those who refused to confess were executed, and it all came to a head on the 22nd, when the final victims were all hanged from the same tree.
Dun dun dun. Mm. Hey, as you deal with the show that deals with history, I mean, is it tough to navigate through history and some, you know, a lot of stuff we know, some stuff we don't know? I mean, how do you fact check everything and, you know, work your way through all that?
Well, I was actually always, I loved history, and, you know, being on this show is really kind of like sweet and nice and easy for me. It's really a lot of fun, because every time you think you know about the era that we're going to go and visit, our historians, you know, they pull out some details that you're kind of like, you never heard of. And you're kind of like, wait, this really happened?
Really? You
know? Every time, I know so many people, after the show is over, they go Wikipedia or encyclopedia or whatever, and they're like fact checking, no way, this is not. And then, oh my God, really? We never heard about it.
Yeah.
You know, so we're kind of trying to find these things in history that are not in books, that, you know, they kind of got forgotten or ran by. Or
what other eras have you done? You did the Salem witch trials.
In this season, yeah, there was Salem witch trials. Next episode, I think we're gonna see young JFK.
I would love to travel back to that time.
Yeah. We've been in during the Watergate, President Nixon presidency. So many interesting parts in United States history, but also we've been in Paris when Charles Lindbergh was landing in Paris. You know, actually my character shot him with the rocket, but. But I didn't want to kill him, just hurt a little bit.
Now, I read one story. You had to, I think there was a scene where Abraham Lincoln was shot, and your character did the thing.
Yeah.
And you had to call your son to say, hey, don't, you know.
Well, it wasn't just like that, but while I was doing the scene, and I'm like, oh my God, my son just was learning in school about all of this, you know, Abraham Lincoln. And, and I'm like, before, and he loves the show, and I'm like, okay. We need to have a little conversation. Dad's going to do something that's really bad. But, you know, it would happen anyway in history. So I'm just kind of doing it because the other guy didn't want to do it.
Right.
I'm like, okay, let me explain again. So, but, yeah, it was sometimes there are tricky aspects of playing a
Imagine
guy
like,
who's
yeah.
not a good guy.
Yeah, who shot Lincoln?
Yeah.
All right, don't miss him. Goran Visnjic. Goran Visnjic. It's a little crazy pronunciation with the end. Visnjic. In Timeless, Sundays, 10 p.m. NBC. It would be an honor, sir. Fist bump to make it official.
Thank you. Boom.
Boom. There it is.